the insurance companies know which ones will go to trial and do a good job and which ones will not. You should too.
If you've been injured and need to hire an attorney, how do you know you're hiring the right attorney for you? Well, that's what we're going to ask the lawyer on this episode. Hi again, everybody. I'm Rob Rosenthal with AskTheLawyers.com. And my guest is attorney Jack Hickey with Hickey Law Firm in Miami. Jack, thank you for making some time to answer our questions today.
Thank you, Rob. Good to see you.
So someone's been injured, maybe seriously injured, and due to someone else's negligence, and they need to hire an attorney. What are the first steps? How do they pick somebody, Jack?
So that's a really good question. First of all, like anything, do your homework. Go online. Look at the background of the attorney and look for a couple of things. Here's what to look for.
Okay.
Look for someone who only does personal injury. That's what I would say, number one. Want somebody that's done that same kind of case, or generally speaking, that kind of case over and over. Mm-hmm. Number two, you want to look at or look for somebody who has, in Florida, we have board certification, and that's a Florida bar sponsored and also sponsored by the National Board of Trial Advocacy, a certification that lawyer is a specialist in certain areas, personal injury, admiralty and maritime, other areas. So you want to look for board certification. Are they board certified? And number three, I think you want to look for results. You know, you want to look to see that particular lawyer has the results to back up what they're saying. Anybody can say that they're a good lawyer and they're kind and they're compassionate and things like that. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, though, have they gotten results and do they go to trial? Those are the things that every consumer really should look for.
You mentioned certification. Is that a rare thing, those board certifications, or does pretty much everybody have those?
So certification is something that very few attorneys have, and it is a real indication of specialization. There's the National Board of Trial Advocacy, NBTA, which has a certification. I am a board certified civil trial lawyer that's nationally by the National Board of Trial Advocacy, and also in Florida by the Florida Bar. I'm also board certified in Admiralty and Maritime. So board certification it's the top, I think it's 7% of all lawyers in the state of Florida. Only 7% are board certified. I'm double board certified, and that's a very, very, very small number. Just a handful of lawyers in the state of Florida are double board certified.
You mentioned, you mentioned finding somebody who goes to trial. I think most people may think, well, everybody's a trial attorney. If they're an attorney, they're a trial attorney. Explain what that means and how that may not be true.
So everybody, there is a label of trial attorney. I'm a trial attorney. A lot of people say that they're trial attorneys, and that's kind of code for representing people, representing consumers in personal injury cases. You want to look for somebody who actually has gone to trial and actually gets results. You know, the insurance companies and the large corporations that, frankly, that get sued, they do this. They rank attorneys. You should, too. Get the attorneys who the insurance companies are, frankly, pretty afraid of and who have a reputation for really walloping them in trial. Go on our website. We share our results with you. We got, for example, we collected on just a few months ago an arbitration which took place over 21 days, and it resulted in $10.5 million against Royal Caribbean Cruise Line. So we've got the results to back up what we say.
Is it important, Jack, for me to have a local attorney for my personal injury case, or can someone farther away help me? What's your advice there?
So that's a good question. You know, for example, in a cruise line case, the major cruise lines, Royal Caribbean, Celebrity, Norwegian Cruise Line, and Carnival Cruise Line, requires that you file suit in Miami, Florida. Mm. So you want The consumer one should absolutely look for and retain somebody who's A, specializing in maritime, B, knows the cruise line business, and C, is in Miami, Florida. This is where the juries are. This is where the judges are. We make appearances, for example, in the cruise line cases, we make appearances all the time. All the judges know us. We see the judges at bar events. We get to know them. And so it's invaluable to have a maritime attorney in Miami, Florida. As to which one, you know, again, look for the board certification. Look for double board certification. Admiralty and maritime law on the one hand, for those cases, because admiralty law applies. And on the other hand, also board certification in trial law, because it all comes down to, can you try the case? And the companies are assessing you, are judging the attorneys, rather, me and every other attorney, as to whether they go to trial. The insurance companies know which ones will go to trial and do a good job and which ones will not. You should too.
So obviously the insurance companies, they would prefer an attorney who's quick to settle, will take an early offer and settle, right?
That's right. And, you know, sometimes the attorney needs the money more than you do. We certainly don't. You can see our results. We knock on wood with a lot of hard work, some luck, some talent, et cetera. We've been very successful over the years. And so, we put our clients first, and we are ready, willing, and able to go to trial. Everybody knows it. Every lawyer knows it. Every insurance company knows it. Every cruise line knows it. And it's a fact.
So, Jack, we've talked a little bit about how someone with a case may pick an attorney. Let's turn it around a little bit. What is the process for a good attorney, a good personal injury attorney, that they go through when they decide whether to take a case or not?
Okay. So this is what I tell everybody who calls me. And I talk to people all the time. Every day I talk to people on the phone. Mm-hmm. And here's what I tell them. And that is, look, every attorney analyzes a case in basically two parts, right? The first part is, we call it liability. Who's at fault? Mm-hmm. Is someone at fault other than you? Is someone at fault that fault has caused the accident? Was someone negligent for leaving a puddle of water on a floor? Was someone negligent for, you know, running through a stop sign and hitting your car, mm-hmm. right? So that's the first thing. And that, if you don't get past that, you don't get any damages. It doesn't matter, you know, how injured, how badly right. injured you were in this incident. This car crash, this slip and fall, this medical malpractice, doesn't matter if you can't prove the fault part of it, right? Mm-hmm. And we look at the fault of what we call the defendant, the person we sue, the corporation we sue, or the other driver. And it's really, when you sue the other driver, it's just the insurance company. Sure. It's their insurance company that makes an appearance and defends them. So that's who we're really worried about. But, you know, what they do is they look at their own fault, and then they try to turn the fault back on the injured person and say, hey, it's your fault too. So there's a comparison. We look at that too, number one. Okay. Number two is, you look at what we call damages. It's really the injuries. Mm-hmm. And I lecture and have prepared outlines on how do you evaluate the value of a personal injury, the severity of an injury. And when you talk about an injury, you want to talk about a particular diagnosis of your doctor, of your hospital. Is it a fractured arm? Okay. Is it the left arm or right arm? Where? What bones? Is it? Oh, it's a fracture of the tibia or the fibula. Those are the tibia and fibula are the lower leg bones, or is it the radius and ulna, the lower arm bones? And so how bad is it? So we look at various medical records, and of course, we talk to the consumer, you, the consumer, and we ask, okay, what was it? A lot of people don't know exactly the extent of it. They were told by their doctor. Then we look at the medical records, the radiology report, let's say it's an arm, and we look at, you know, how bad was the fracture and are there bone fragments in there? And then what was done? Was there surgery? Was the surgery open, where they actually open the skin and the muscle and everything, and they insert plate and screws in there, or there was no surgery? That affects the value. And then finally, you know, it all comes down to, okay, how are you now? Did you go from being able to use your arm, if it's an arm injury, for example, to I can't use it anymore because of the fracture and because of complications from the fracture, from the surgery? Or are you back pitching for the New York Yankees? You know, there's a big difference there. And if you're back pitching for the New York Yankees, or you're back, you had a leg injury and you're back running marathons, well, that's good for you, not good for the case. But if you're disabled or impaired somewhat, you limp now, or you can't use your arm, if it's an arm injury, then that affects the value of the case. We look at that.
A lot of great information as always, Jack. Thank you so much. I think you've helped a lot of people today. I appreciate it.
Well, thank you, Rob.
That's going to do it. That's going to do it for this episode of Ask the Lawyer. My guest has been Attorney Jack Hickey of Miami. If you want the best information, or you're ready to choose a lawyer that lawyers choose, make sure to go to askthelawyers.com. Also, please take a second to like, share, and subscribe by clicking below. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm Rob Rosenthal with askthelawyers.com.